All right, today's video is gonna be about how to get ready for a long thru hike or just to get into backpacking shape. This is what I do. This may not work for you, but some of these tips you might be able to find useful. What I like to do is about 6 months in advance, start getting into shape. And you'd think that includes going to the gym, exercising, doing all that stuff, getting fit. It's right around the holidays and I'm a little fat right now, so it's time to start getting in shape for this summer's hiking season. Now, what I have found is the best way to get into shape for hiking is to actually go hiking. So I like to get into shape to do maybe a 10-mile day carrying about 35 pounds at altitude. So you need to find a hill or a building to climb stairs, something near your house. I live in the bottom of the foothills of the Sierra, so I have a 700-foot hill five minutes from my house. So what I do, I use the backpack that I take on backpacking trips. So I want to load it up, so let's load it up with some stuff. Got some tire chains, those are nice and heavy. Lots of water bottles, some tools in case somebody's car breaks down up there. See, I'm just looking for stuff that's heavy. More water. Oh look, a horseshoe. That'll bring me luck. So load it up with that stuff. Don't forget your first aid kit. And if you use hiking poles on your trip, take those on your training hikes. So let's go for a training hike. Okay, I know I'm in trouble because I just had to loosen my waist strap a lot from the last time I went backpacking this last summer, so good thing I'm out doing this. So let's go for a training hike. So one of the things you can do while you're on your training hikes is to find likely spots to do other exercises. At the end of this video, I'll list all the exercises that you can use. It's not all of them, but the ones that are useful for getting in backpacking shape. So there's this rock up here. This is a great exercise for getting in shape for going up hills and backpacking. These are called step-ups. So you just go up on one foot, do as many reps as you're comfortable with, then switch feet. And you can do what's called step downs too. Step downs are like that, or you can do side steps. So that's a great exercise. And one thing that's often overlooked by backpackers is balance. Especially as older folks have trouble with balance when you're doing those log crossings. Find some logs with your backpack on, you know, and work on your balance. And you know, just a 1 foot stand, even in front of the TV, is great. So while you're doing your training hikes, do some of those other exercises along the way. All right, we made it. So, a couple of funny stories. This one time, I was lucky enough to get to go to Alaska and do some backcountry fishing for a week. And when I came back to Sacramento to the airport, I got a ride downtown, but I needed to walk several blocks to my girlfriend's car to get a ride home. So here I am with a backpack, fishing pole, been in the backcountry for a week, and usually the homeless people pretty much ignore you, but all these homeless guys were coming up to me. Oh, where's your camping spot? Do you know where the fish are biting? It was just a different world that I was not invisible to the homeless people. But a word about backpacks and walking around with a backpack around town when you're not actually on a backpacking trip. You'll occasionally see a guy walking around the neighborhood, maybe walking his dogs. You guys know who you are. You know, take a look at them. If they looks like an expensive backpack, or if you get close to them and they don't smell too bad, chances are those guys are training for a really cool hike. And chat them up, see what they're doing to get in shape, and I'll guarantee you those guys are successful on their trips and have a better time because they're preparing and getting in shape. So you know what I like to do? This won't work for everybody, but actually walking is what I like to do best. But to get in shape for hikes, I do go to the gym. I do work out occasionally. not very well. I'd rather go hiking, so I do a lot of that. But there's basically three parts of your body you need to work on. Your lower body, your legs, your core, and your upper body. And again, balance is really important too, so work on your balance. So I think your core is probably really important, and then your legs. Upper body, if you load up a pack and walk around, you're gonna take care of a lot of that stuff yourself. That includes using hiking poles, because that actually causes a little bit of a workout. So I've learned this from experience. When I was in my 20s, at one time, I used to run a lot. I could run a 10K in like 36 minutes, which are 6 minute miles, which is not spectacular, but it's pretty good. And one year I was in like spectacular shape. Been running races, running on the street every day. And me and a buddy went on a pretty heavy duty backpack trip in our 20s. And I died because I wasn't on terrain. I wasn't on hills. I wasn't on the things that I was gonna do. So Sierra hikes, you're gonna go up several thousand feet on most trips and down several thousand feet. So you gotta do hills, you gotta train for what you're doing. The other thing that I think is actually the most important thing to me to prep for a long backpacking trip is the cardio. So when I go to the gym, I tend to just do cardio workouts. I do a lot of elliptical stuff. I love the stair climber too. But just get your heart rate up for a long time. I do about a 50-minute workout. But you need to work those in with your hikes. When you're doing your day hikes, your training hikes, you need to kind of alternate that. You don't want to do that every day. You need to let your muscles rest and do your weight training on different days. I don't do a lot of weight stuff. I mostly do, like I said, I mostly do cardio. So do what works for you. But best of all, get out and do some trips. If you can get some day hikes in, great. Even better, actually get some backpacking trips in. So I am not a fitness expert, as you could probably tell, but I do pretty good on backpacking trips for an older guy. So I'm not going to pretend to tell you what exercises to do, but I will list the exercises that work for each body type, lower core and upper body, some suggestions. I'm not going to explain how to do them because I'll probably tell you the wrong thing to do. So figure out a routine that works for you, and it's never too early to get out and start training. So get out there and start hiking, and your summer hikes are going to be that much more enjoyable if you're ready for them. But don't forget things, look at other activities that are fun that you can do in the winter. Cross-country skiing, snowshoeing, bike riding's great. A lot of those are lower impact things too. So I have to be careful of doing like really heavy impact thing because I have bad knees. But like I said, figure out your routine, tweak it as necessary. Don't take this as rocket science because it's not. It's what works for me, and what works for you will be much different. But get out there and start training, and happy trails.